Today we docked in the Null Island Harbor. There were beautiful long-necked birds, I think cranes, everywhere we looked. We disembarked as the porters ran around behind us, carrying everything to the customs house. The town of Bethesda is muddy and gray, nothing like the tropical paradise I was imagining.
It's not numb yet, so...
Martha and I waited at the hotel while Father got the luggage and looked for the Null Island customs representative. He was supposed to have met us at arrival. Martha and I had a good laugh when Father came back with two oversized straw bonnets made by the local women. They were plain and too large, but tightly woven, so they would last longer than a season. We decided to decorate them and set about finding a shop with dried flowers. The concierge found a small shop that had some. A runner was dispatched and bought all they had. We spent the day at a large table in the hotel lobby decorating our Null Island grand attire.
Thank you.
by the neck ports. We export hail and also.
Father came back to the hotel later, and we had dinner in our private dining room. He'd had little success finding the Null Island customs official. Unfortunately, we had arrived on a local religious holiday, and none of the offices were open. Though I said I was more than glad to have a day without movement. Father liked our hats and told us we'd be the best-dressed ladies in the colony. I'm sure the local society women would agree.
What if Null Island workers, like there's like a really heavy, like in the ocean, like people will try to get lost, and if they drown, they get reincarnated as one of those Null Island workers?
Running water upon a sand in the sky.